Lesson 1-3, Dividing Rational Numbers. So our vocabulary for this lesson is reciprocal. And when you are finding the reciprocal of a number, basically all you're doing is flipping it. So the number on the top becomes the number on the bottom, and the number on the bottom goes to the top. All right, so if you have a fraction, this is very easy to see. If we have 4/6, all right, and we take the reciprocal of that, we end up with 6/4. We're just flipping the numbers, all right? With an integer, we can do the same thing, and it turns into 1/ whatever your integer is. And the reason it does that is that there's a hidden 1 underneath every integer, all right? Every whole number has a 1 as its denominator, okay? The important aspect of reciprocals that we'll use later on is that if you multiply a number by its reciprocal, okay, you're always going to multiply straight across. 3 times 1 is 3, and 1 times 3 is 3, and you're going to end up with the same number for a numerator as you have for the denominator, which means that your fraction is going to be equal to 1. And this is always going to be true for any number, whether it's negative, positive, decimal, fraction, doesn't matter. A reciprocal, or a number times its reciprocal, is always going to be equal to 1. Okay, the first concept we're looking at is dividing fractions. And when we're dividing fractions, we're actually going to use a reciprocal to make the problem easy, because dividing fractions can get pretty complicated. But multiplying fractions, as we did up here, is pretty simple. So instead of dividing 1/2 by 3/4, we're going to keep the first number the same, change the sign from division to multiplication, and then flip the fraction. So 3/4 becomes 4/3. Alright, so if we start with 1/2 divided by 3/4, it's going to become 1/2 times 4/3. Alright, and then once we've done our keep, change, flip, we're going to multiply straight across. 1 times 4 is 4, and 2 times 3 is 6, and we would simplify this by dividing both top and bottom by 2 to get 2/3. And that is it for dividing fractions. Make sure that you remember keep, change, flip, and that you are flipping the second fraction. So you're flipping whatever number you're dividing by. If you try and flip the first number, it's going to give you a different answer. All right, that's it for this lesson.